We're going to cover a lot in this lesson, touching on both design and implementation aspects of animation. Let's start by jumping straight into some code. More specifically, let's look at how building animations with the Android SDK has evolved, from its humble beginnings to the powerful and flexible APIs we have today. From the earliest releases, the Android.view.animation APIs let you move, scale, and fade items on screen. This is available to every device out there, but it's pretty limited. Here's a really simple example. Pressing the button slides it up, fades it out, and then shows a new screen. And here's the code. First, we create some objects like alpha animation and translate animation and combine them together using an animation set. Then, we add a listener, allowing us to run code when the animation ends. In this example, when the animation finishes, we'll start another activity. We're also providing a custom transition, telling the new activity how it should appear on the screen and telling the current activity how it should disappear. Once we call startAnimation on the button, it'll begin to slide and fade, and once those are done, our animation listener will get called. It's worth noting that you could also define these animations in XML and inflate them into real animation objects using animation utils. And here's what the actual XML looks like. Back in the early days, this same XML format was used to describe animations on views as well as transitions for activities. It was really simple, but also really limited. All you could really do was scale, move, rotate, and fade different views or different activities. So around the time of Android 3.0 and 4.0, the animation APIs started receiving a slew of major upgrades. The API for basic view animations got a lot simpler and easier to use. Here's that same animation from before with the new API. Notice how the API uses a fluent interface. You could chain together multiple calls like .animate, .alpha, .translationY. This made for much more compact code. More importantly, you could also now animate any property on any object. So while before you could animate the X position of a view, you could now also animate a button's text color, for example. So here's a quick example of this. And note that the ARGB evaluator tells the object animator what text color to set, ranging between black and red over the course of 1 second.